Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about the optional vouchers and post-dated vouchers. So coming to the optional vouchers, these are used for some specific business purposes, and we are going to do this in our Tally Prime. So I just go on with the sales. Go to the sales. I will make a sales entry now for my customer. And I have one stock item. I'm going to sell it. So I will just view it in my day book. This is my sales entry. And I make a printout of this document. Just go to make a preview for it. You can see it. The document displays as invoice. But when I change it as optional, you can see the status has been changed to the optional, and we can toggle between regular and optional. So the status of this sales voucher is now optional. So when I make a printout of this document, you can see that it turns to pro forma invoice. So whenever the sales document has been converted to the optional, this entry will not be displayed in our balance sheet. Just show the balance sheet. So in our balance sheet, you can see we have a current asset, that is the closing stock. So you can see here the sundry debtor is not displayed here. So I just go to the display more reports, enter to the exception reports, into the optional vouchers. So it is stated for April 1. I just changed the date as 1/1/2022, and you can see our post-dated sales voucher appears in this report. So now I'm going to change the status of the sales voucher as regular. So I just save it, the whole document, once again, so that it will change its status. And now when I go and look into the balance sheet, just enter into the current asset, you can see the sundry debtor field displays here with the customer, the debit side, and the closing stock disappears since I have made a sales to the customer. And this is for sales voucher. And the similar thing can be done with the sales order also. I just enter into the voucher. I will make a sales order now. Show inactive. You can take it, the sales order, from the list over here. I will activate it. I will make a sales order to my customer. No inventory, but I will just make some sales order. So this is the normal sales order. I just click on page up so that the sales order will be displayed. And now when I make a printout of this sales order, you can view it as sales order in my invoice. But when I change the status to the optional, when I make a printout of this, we can see it as a quotation. So this is the application for optional voucher. So when I make a sales document, when I convert it to the optional, it will be displayed as a pro forma invoice. And when I make a sales order, when I convert it into the optional voucher, it will be displayed as quotation. So this is the application for our optional vouchers. So once the document is converted to the optional, it won't be displayed or reflected in the balance sheet. So this is not only applicable for sales and sales order, but also it is applicable for other entries like payments, receipts also. Once the entry is converted to the optional, it won't be reflected into the balance sheet. and it can be toggled between optional and regular. Whenever it is needed, it can be toggled between the optional and the regular. So once the document is made as optional, it will be displayed in the exception reports of the in our reports column. So these are the implementation for optional vouchers. And now I'm going to move on with the post-stated vouchers. So in order to make the post-stated vouchers more easy, I have made this question. Say for example, this is today's date, and our ABC company will pay its vendor a sum of 10,000 through its SBI bank account with a check number 1, but it is post-stated to 1/2/2022, which means I am making the payment on this date, but in the check what I have provided to the vendor is post-stated to 1/2/2022. So this is the question for this post-stated vouchers, and we are going to do in our Tally Prime. So I just go back. I will just first create a bank account. Create a new bank account named SB Bank. This is my company bank account. So I just enter some account number, IFSC code. That's not an issue. The branch. And set alter checkbook. I just give enter yes for this, so that I can give the check number. My first check number will be displayed like this number, and the last check number of this book I will make it as 25. So I have 25 check numbers in my first checkbook. I will name this checkbook as book 1 or checkbook 1. So if this checkbook is completed, I will get a new checkbook, and at that time I will enter the next sequence number here, but currently I'm now leave it as it is, and enable check printing yes, and set alter check printing configuration I will give it as yes, and this is the printing configuration for my check. So I just copy from the sample format. So I can vary this also, not to a greater extent, but I can modify some with some small values. I can modify it also. So during my printing of the check, I will get it like this. So when I make the check, it will be printed like this. Give escape, and I will make some opening balance to my bank. So I have created my bank. Now I'm going to do the post-stated entry in my Tally Prime. So the entry is payment. As we have discussed, the payment should be made on the first step for doing this post-stated voucher is the payment should be made on this date, the 1st of February. So I just change the date over here by clicking on F2. The date should be 1/2/2022. So the first step has been done. The second step is the entry should be changed to post-stated. But before that, I just make the journal. The debit is vendor, say for 10,000 rupees. Okay. Through my bank, I'm going to pay. I just go with SBI Bank. The payment medium or the transaction type is by check. And the instrument number, that is the check number here, is first check number 1. And but before going on to this, I just want to perform the second step. I just click on escape. Okay. okay, in this state I need to perform the second step, that is the entry should be changed to the post stated. So I click on post stated. You can see here the status has been changed to post stated. So I have performed the step one, that is I have changed the day to the 1st of February, but today's date is 1st of Jan. And the second step is I have done the entry, but I have changed the status to the post stated, and just click on enter. Here you can give the instrument number, that is a check number as first check, and you can see the instrument date is 1st of February. That is the check validity date, or in this date only I can make this payment by bank. The important step is the PTC issue date. That is the third step. PTC is the post dated check issue date. The check issue date is nothing but the check issue date, that is 1st of Jan. But the actual payment will be made on 1st of February only. There is a note of PTC post dated check issued note. Just leave it as it is. I'm just accepting this entry. You can see here the check will be printed like this. Okay, the entry has been made. So in my balance sheet, I just view my balance sheet. Okay, this is the payment has been made in the February, and this report is stated the Jan month. Just go to the current asset, the bank account. You can see the bank is having its opening balance for the April month. So I just change the period as 1/2/2022 to 1/3/2022. You can see the bank has been debited with 10,000 rupees, which means the amount has been sent to the vendor in the 1st of February and not in the Jan. We can also view the report in my exception reports, the post dated voucher. So the actual entry appears in Jan when I you can see the okay I just changed the date as 1/1/2021. There is no entry, but the actual entry will display in the state. So that's all about the post dated voucher. So these three steps will make the post dated voucher a simple one. So thank you guys for watching this video. We will have a new session with a new video. Thank you.